She's not those kids. Get to know her. She's very good.
And they stay fresh, as long as bags.
Yeah.
single teeth, they're all like different. Her dogs and my dogs are not really any different. My dogs did get the message that they're the longest shelter dogs, and they can demand to be better. Every once in a while, somebody will give me a bag of nice stuff for my dog.
Yeah.
This stuff tastes good, and everyone should chew it for a half hour, like, what do you think?
You know what my dog loves now? Apples.
Really? Grapes likes apples.
And frozen pears.
For goodness sake.
He loves frozen pears.
Did you know that, wow, did you know that the, you made me think of this when you said his name. Did you know that the reason dogs can't eat grapes is within the skin, it's not the grapes themselves. So did you know that if you froze them and then you take them out and you let them start to defrost, you can like pinch them kind of like their mommies.
Oh,
and
yeah.
The skin just slips right off and they can eat those grapes all they want.
I mean, they should for the sugar.
But it's just no skin. It just can't have a skin.
Would you say
what?
Yeah. Hi, honey. Yeah, I've got a friend of mine, and that's what she does. She buys a bunch of grapes, puts them in the freezer for like a little while so they start to freeze, pulls them out, and then pops them all out of the skin and puts them back in the freezer for exactly that reason. So she tosses them, like, she gets ice cubes for her drink, and she gives her, tosses the grapes for her.
It's just awesome.
Like refreshing. And, you know.
Yeah.
And probably, yeah. And the texture, the crunchy. Uh-huh.
There's
water.
And there's
water.
Brian's
got his joke.
What
is he? He's really enjoying his jokes. Yeah. Tell Bonnie.
I think Monkey is waiting for something from someone.
I don't
know. Ah! No, my dog.
That's how I feel when I'm leaving the dogs also. I very sad.
I know she wanted to get out.
I looked down.
Yeah.
Probably ride all the dogs. She's,
yeah.
Yeah.
They're
probably so.
Get it on.
knows that it's the Esbern. And he was turning his head sideways. He was trying to get his mouth on the Esbern. He just doesn't know that he has to, like, turn it and twist it.
He's
looking at me like, oh, come on.
Oh.
I just couldn't believe it.
So monkey's a very appropriate name.
Impressive.
Find him
as it turns out.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Pretty impressive.
So, what do you think?
I woke
up Wednesday.
I'm here.
What do you think?
Yeah.
And while I'm waiting for Laura to come and give me the computer, I go and look at the, you know, the locker that has all the pieces. Oh, look at that. Great. All the harnesses. Remember, I was a little crazy trying to find them? She wears a harness all the time, and it's because she can be really reactive, so her foster needs to be able to, like, reach down and grab the harness if necessary. Mm-hmm. So it's the kind of harness that's, it's got, like, a padded chest plate, and so it's totally fine.
It's different.
These are meant to be, like,
for walking.
Yeah. You know, so you can see it. It makes them really bright. Mm-hmm.
Your eyes are the exact same color as your hair.
Well, I mean, they know that it's going to, you know. Well, it's amazing how some of them are so, he's a different walker with his harness on.
I don't think that's
he's strong, but
it could be.
You know what you're doing, Dawn.
I think he just might be stronger than I am. But, you know, I took him down the steps first. You know, and it's like easy.
So, no, here's what you do. You go down the first flight of steps, and then you tell them, wait, every single one that I go down, that's when they can do. You get to the landing, and they wait. And if they start to move, I'll let them continue. I'll pull them back up to the top step, and I'll say, wait. And then when they stop, then I say, yes, and then we go down. So, if you do that with them each time, they come to learn this one now. When I brought him down yesterday, we got to the top of the stairs and looked at him and went, good boy, yes. And we went down. And then we got to the landing, you know, the little GDS right there.
Yeah.
And he stopped and looked at him.
Yes.
And we went down. So if you're consistent with it, they learn really quickly that you don't get wrong.
Okay.
Because I can't move that fast.
No, me either. So when they pause, they get the idea to slow down or like it takes.
So I use weight. I use it at the top of the stairs, and then we get to the first landing.
Yeah.
Again, wait. And when they look at me, then I say yes, and then we go down.
Okay.
Great idea.
Okay. That's going to be the one bad thing I have to say about it. It's great, but you won't have to. But it is something that's helpful. It's another train for you.
Right. Yeah.
But I'm excited about the relationship because we're going to unlock the space when I told her what I wanted to do with a big
pen,
like a big pen inside for me for his office use treats, being introducing these dogs to each other to see if they can train them up. And I said I want to have top dogs come out, they can teach volunteers how to use these boxes. We've got four, and we're not going to, I think it's going to be like this a lot over in that new location, especially for a while, because you're not going to have just the random people coming through like we do here.
Yeah.
I don't think our numbers and adoptions and fosters are going to change a whole lot. I think that's going to be pretty consistent, because most of the people that choose an adopt or foster are not all walkers.
Yeah.
You know, they're not just visiting.
Yeah, they're all
the home with a dog today. Those are intentional. So I don't think that's going to be that we're going to have a lot of time. So if we've got all that time, and we've got 8 or 10 dogs every day, why not take advantage of it? And every hour spend, you should only spend ideally, training sessions should be about 10 minutes long. You should always finish on a high dose.
Yeah.
You keep going until you fail.
Yeah.
That's how some trainers tell people, and I think that's wrong. If you continue until you fail, and that's the way it's going to be. That's about what we're doing. Working with them 10 minutes, let's say they're there with us 4 hours a day, 10 minutes a day, that's 40 minutes.